send us the detailed descriptions of the products. Alright, sir? Anything else?
Also mention, yes, sir, that all the enclosed documents, yes, should be signed by each company representative.
Signed by company's representatives. Okay, sir. Anything else?
Soon you'll be able to write your own emails.
Yes.
But sir, that's not what I want to do. I have this idea where I want to put all our products on a catalog of our web page. You know, we can sell.
If we get this tender, it will be very beneficial for our company. I do hope you realize how important it is.
Yes, sir. Certainly.
How's it going?
It's almost done, sir. Just checking for any corrections.
Send this to my personal ID, and here's the send button.
Okay, sir. I'll take a leave, sir.
You don't seem to be suffering from any kind of cold. Then why is it that you're coughing? And that too at the start, middle and end of every sentence.
What else should I do than cough? Tell me, what else is there to do? Excuse me, sir.
Since when did you guys stick to smoking?
Well, we didn't record the date. Maybe a year or two. What was I telling
you? My young friends, it's been years since these cartons began announcing that cigarette smoking is injurious to health. Look, it is okay for all those people who were addicted to it much before the warning started appearing on the packs. But what made you guys do it? Why did you pledge your health to the vampires of tobacco?
Pledge your health? Whose health? Yours or ours?
You consider yourself very smart, don't you? Tell me something. Are you the maker of your health and body? Did you know you would be born as a male or female, tall or short, fair or dark, fat or thin? It is you who is responsible for the immunity of your body against adulteration and pollution. Must you gamble with your health?
Let's go, man.
Exactly.
Pardon me, sir, but are you married?
What do you gain by asking such a question to a man your father's age?
Well, I gain nothing, but you could have. From the statutory warning against sex, pronounced by seers and sages for thousands of years? I wonder, what made you ignore that?
Look, young woman, what you advance is hardly an argument. Nature has endowed us with basic instincts, much before man appeared.
There he goes again.
Can you say the same thing about a cigarette?
Take it, man. I get my.
Can you classify smoking as an instinct? Don't walk away. An argument must be met with an argument, and not with giggles and retorts. Here, take a cigarette.
But sir, will you please tell me what inspired you to come out with such preachings against smoking?
What inspired the authorities to put these warnings on the cigarette cartons? Duty. Am I clear?
Please go on with your duties, sir. Cheers.
Hey, wait for me.
You know, a sage once said, there are five kinds of people who are not governed by any reason.
I'm sorry, what?
I said, there are five kinds of people who are not governed by any reason. The first being a child. The second is the stupid. Third, the wicked, followed by the lunatic. And finally, the mystique. What category do you think these kids belong to? Wicked?
I think you dropped something.
Or I prefer lunatic. That way there is some hope for humanity. Book or no book? Relax at the air condition for a while. What use is this book to you at this age?
Why don't you use it on your head before giving it away? Keep sitting. But if you don't mind,
yeah?
Would you please comb your hair?
Beg your pardon?
I mean, it looks so unkempt. Won't you care for your head?
So if you're talking about my head, I would like you to leave it in peace because it is my head.
Look here, my friend. Not many are blessed with such a treasure of silken hair. You have not neglected an inch of your persona. Even your face is so well rouged. So why are you so unkind towards your head?
What have I done to you that you demean me like this?
Believe me, I have no intention to demean you. I mean what I say sincerely. You have, don't you, a comb in your pocket?
Who said I have?
How dare you challenge the truth, you liar?
How dare you call me a liar, you stranger?
Would you like to know how? Who do you think paid for the comb you have just pocketed?
So much for a comb?
It's not about just a comb.
Then?
Which delusion? You will come with me and buy your comb.
Venerable one. Why don't you go back to the bookshelf and spend your remaining eyesight on the erotica, on Italian art paper, or whatever?
Mental case?
How dare you take me for mad?
Excuse me, sir. Which book are you looking for?
For? No book.
Why then are you here?
Because I will to be here. I'm not an intruder.
Strange. There are people who come to bookstores to pick up quarrels. Anyway, all those who would like to make a purchase, please move to the counters. Others may leave. You. It's because of you that I've been called a mental case.
Hey, driver, let's go.
Where do you think you're going?